fell in.
About Minecraft, also known as the series where Dream inevitably gets tagged, even though this is basic shit and will not help him in any shape, way, or form. Cats are great because creepers are actually scared of them. Phantoms. See how the cats hiss at them? Something else interesting about cats, they're immune to fall damage. Creepers, can climb ladders. In the mushroom biomes, no hostile mobs will spawn. That includes in the caves underneath. Mobs won't spawn on glass or slabs that are placed on the bottom half of a block, however, of course, they will walk on them. If you're ever digging straight up, always place a torch on the block you're standing on, just in case there's a lot of gravel above you, because then you won't suffocate. For some reason, hoglins don't attack you when you have them on a lead.
3, 2, 1, go. Sorry, not strong. Good speed. Use the tree. Use the tree. Over the hill. Grab the pick. Clean. That's a good pick grab. You have to complete the ravine jump right here. Oh my god.
It's a door. Oh, Dream's here. Dream's opening the doors.
So here I stood still because when you move, you make particles on the block on the ground. And I saw George coming, so I thought, oh, I need to stand still. Otherwise, he's going to see my block particles because the block particles are way more obvious than the invisibility particles.
I hear the door.
Don't close this, you muffin. Literally, the door
He opened an iron door. I heard it.
No. So I'm actually pretty sure that I bumped bad there, and he didn't realize because Sapnap was right next to him, and I think he just assumed it was Sapnap. I mean, because nobody's going to be thinking, oh, someone invisible just bumped into me.
There's literally a door right here, George.
It was an iron door. I heard
George.
It.
No, George.
Literally just block it.
He's
right filling
here. In the portal.
So Bad was trying to run to me to attack me, and he ran through the empty portal because it was the quickest way. And then when he was in the portal, I placed the final ender eye, so he instantly got teleported to the end. I saw people confused about that, like, how did he get to the end? When did he get to the end? And most people didn't realize that he went to the end right then.
He's there!
Really found it in. Oh my goodness!
Alright, it's been a while, so I figured I'd show you guys my new house.
It's kind of small inside, but I mean, I don't know. I think it's cozy. I like it. It's not too bad. Another thing that you guys told me about is if I use two things of water like this, that it makes an infinite water source. I haven't really figured out how it works yet, but thanks for letting me know about that. And then, oh yeah, yeah, another thing is when I made the end portal, you guys told me that I don't need to use the corners, so I saved myself some obsidian there. But I think in this video, we're gonna go to the end. Alright, and there's the Ender Dragon. I only have one arrow, so I really gotta make it count. I hope I can hit my shot. I mean, what? I hit it, but maybe this thing is like keeping it alive or something? If I just destroy this thing, it'll die.
You seemed to like this last time, so here are five more differences between Java Edition and Bedrock Edition. I'm on top of the Nether right now in Bedrock Edition, and I cannot build. I can build down there, not up here. Over on Java Edition, I can build up to 128 blocks up. On Bedrock Edition, you can fill cauldrons with dye to dye your leather armor, or with potions to tip your arrows with that potion. This just isn't going to work on Java Edition at all. Java Edition will start killing entities if there are too many in the same space. But Bedrock Edition has no limit on this. Java Edition has the killer bunny. It can only be cheated in, but it still exists. But on Bedrock Edition, it doesn't exist at all. You can place ahead of you in Bedrock Edition, which is really useful. But in Java, you have to place it on the side of the block.
It's not about winning, it's about fun.
What's that?
Fun is, it's like happy friends who do stuff together. U is for you and me. N is for anywhere and anytime at all.
Down here in the deep blue sea.
That's completely idiotic.